Hello there and welcome to the end of Team of the Year. This is a video, to be honest, I didn't really want to have to make for this year in FIFA. Last year, I was very close to making this video, but I felt like this year especially hit on a different note. I think I'll happily speak for all of us right now and say that Team of the Year did not deliver anywhere near the potential that the biggest promo of the entire calendar could reach. The capability, the amount of better cards chosen by the content team could be amazing. And instead, we got kind of peculiar choices like Sabitzer from Leipzig, which now costs 570,000 coins to be exact. There are so many ways that EA could have gone down the road of doing more repeatable packs, more repeatable player picks, obviously better pack look, but I think I've got to make this today. It's been a while since the last kind of, I guess what you want to call it, rant video or whichever, but I want to make this like very constructive, very easy for EA to follow in terms of the feedback from the community. And I've got to say it straight from the get-go, I just feel like even 3 days prior to the end of Team of the Year, which is literally the biggest, the best, you know, chance to get, well, not best chance actually, but best players, right? It's the best players in the game at this stage of FIFA. This promo felt so just quiet 3 days prior. I got so many tweets from you guys saying, Matt, this promo has been like a 2 out of 10. Matt, this promo has been like a 3 out of 10. And I think it's the fact that like, firstly, the pack look is and has been the worst I've ever seen in any Team of the Year promo. Some friends of mine spent 700,000 FIFA points, guys, and didn't get a single Team of the Year. I believe Haber spent 600,000 points, I think more actually, and at that stage, he did not pack a single Team of the Year plus 5 million coins worth of packs. The upgrade packs that we grinded on stream, guys, it was awesome, right? We did that live as well a lot of the time, and like, overall, on streams on Twitch this week, which, by the way, have been incredible. Thank you guys for the support, man. It's been insane. 1,300 packs grinded, one Team of the Year, and then one from a FIFA point pack on, I think it was, 2 days ago. So it goes to show, like, literally two Team of the Years, guys, from about 1,300 packs was the kind of look we were getting. And that was from so many League SBCs. There's been so much content like that. And overall, the biggest thing to address is obviously the pack look. The FIFA points issue keeps marching forward, and it should do, in my opinion. I just think it's been the worst look by far. Even on like the 100k packs, it would say less than 1% chance of getting Team of the Year. They have to look into how to balancing the points issue, because obviously it's just insane at this point. The player choices from the SBCs, not having a single Thomas Muller SBC or Thiago SBC has been insane. You know, having Nabil Fekir as a choice in the honorable mentions has been kind of crazy to me. I've really hated how we haven't had, other than obviously the upgrade packs, we haven't had much in terms of repeatable player picks at all. We could have had an end of era Rooney card. We never got that. There's so many different routes that could have gone down, and it's just not been done. My biggest point is, guys, a Team of the Year promo, it should feel like it's what, an at least 8 out of 10 promo. For me, personally speaking, I'm going to say, for me, I think this is probably a 2 out of 10 in terms of the overall promo. The pack look, I've never seen a Team of the Year like this. The players chosen for SBCs. The only brilliant thing, in my opinion, of Team of the Year, I will say now, is the flashback Ronaldo. EA did a great job on the flashback Ronaldo, and obviously you could still grind that card as well. Andy Ball and I think Boateng, but just so many choices that I was just left a bit baffled by in terms of card select. And hoping EA watching this, because I really want them to know that the flashback content was great. Ronaldo flashback card, we want more of that. Lionel Messi, a Santos Neymar, you know what I mean? Those kind of cards are what we want to see. We also want to see so much more utilization of objective cards. For example, I think Jack Grealish, we can still unlock in FIFA 21. right now, but that's another route they need to go down more, because objective cards from grinding in this game this year have been some of the most fun I've had, and maybe you guys have had, from this FIFA. You know, even grinding to get Gonzalo Gudeis, I found fun, and now I've got a very good card to get. The Team of the Year loan Messi, also a big win from EA. That was very good, EA. And the content team, please watch this. That was great. The flashback Ronaldo SBC might be one of the best. I still think they could have improved a few more stats, like, with not much more improvement, but still, you know what I mean? Like, that kind of hype around a flashback card was awesome. And I think we just need so much better pack luck. That's got to happen. Last year, I think I packed 5 Team of the Years. This year, I am probably going to finish with 2, unless on the final send on Twitch tomorrow. But overall, it just feels so underwhelming. The fact that 3 days prior to Team of the Year ending, guys, I was not even really bothered about grinding for Weekend League to get packs for like next week. I mean, we shouldn't be wanting to play a different game during Team of the Year. We shouldn't be loading up FIFA at 6 p.m. and 7:30 and feeling disappointed. I believe that more creativity needs to go into the players chosen. We shouldn't be paying 573,000 coins for a Sabitzer SBC. We shouldn't be not hyped for any Team of the Year content. Team of the Year should be incredibly hype. We should have had 86 plus player upgrade packs. We should have had repeatable player upgrade packs. Well, player picks, sorry. The upgrade packs in general, I've never seen pack look like it, because Team of the Season, I got like 4 or 5 out of 10 Premier League Team of the Season last promo in the FIFA 20 promo. Guys, we did 1,300 upgrade packs on stream this week, and we packed 1 Team of the Year, and most of them were premium upgrades. That's how bad though they were. So for me overall, I'm going to rate Team of the Year, guys, 2 out of 10. And it does, in a way, I think we're all gutted. Honestly, I think we're all like, damn, this promo just didn't deliver. I think the Sabitzer SBC was a bit like a slap in the face from, you know, just in terms of the content. It's like, damn, all the grind we've done this week, and, you know, it would have been great to have a banging final card released for the honorable mentions, and just Sabitzer is not the one. Like, there's so many more, I guess, interesting choices that could have gone down the route of. We could have even maybe got a Team of the Week upgrade pack that was maybe 81 rating, but you get like an 83 plus Team of the Week, things like that. Just so much more creativity, in my opinion, guys, needs to go in to these kind of promos. And it's the biggest promo of the year. Yet we all know Team of the Season is always better. Team of the Year should be a banging 8, 9 out of 10, 10 out of 10 promo. And I just feel like there's been so much good opportunities missed with this promo. It is insane. Like, it really is when it boils down to it. Like, the amount of, like, ideas they could have gone down in terms of more flashback content, because we saw the hype of Ronaldo. That would have been amazing to see, maybe a flashback Kante, a flashback Varane, a flashback pretty, I guess, hilarious David Luiz or Dani Alves card. That would have been nice. Maybe not Dani Alves because he's not on the game, I don't think. But David Luiz could have been pretty cool, right? Just some cool concepts. That would have been really nice. But in terms of what we're all saying, guys, in the community itself. So I tweeted out before, and no 7:30 p.m. content to end Team of the Year. We'll do a final send for tomorrow's stream with League SBC packs to pack my 3rd Team of the Year, hopefully. What would you rate this Team of the Year promo out of 10? And Noah replied saying 81 plus league upgrade packs for the final day. Again, I definitely agree with this. We've just got, guys, this content in FIFA right now, which is here. So we've got the 83 plus defender, midfielder, and attacker. Now, I like the idea of these SBCs, EA, but in my opinion, what you guys should have done at the content team is A, not make it 83 rating, because I've seen so many 83 double packs in these. This should probably be 81. That would be a good start. Then, probably 60 chemistry. Finally, make all of these repeatable for the final day, right? And if they do that, maybe do go to 82 rating, because obviously these could be potentially really good to do. But for the final day, you've got to release something great. Sabitzer should probably be maxed 1 squad. I don't think he should be three squads. That's just incredibly expensive for a card that isn't really, other than Bundesliga, that linkable in terms of, you know, his card. Obviously, if this guy was in the Premier League, then yeah, that'd be very, I guess, interesting. But I mean, yeah, the Bundesliga is just simply not as hype. And, you know, speaking of Bundesliga, I think we're about to sign, is it Kabak from Schalke today? So let's go. Two more defenders, Liverpool guys, let's get it. Anyway, these should be repeatable. This card should not have been on the game unless it was one squad. He is nearly 600,000 coins. We should have had maybe an 84 plus, maybe repeatable player upgrade pack. That could have been a thing. We could have had another 86 plus upgrade pack. That would have been great. There's just been, yeah, like this team of the year challenge, it's team of the year, EA, and we need better packs than that. That should be maybe a rare Electrum pack or a mega pack. We need, most importantly though as well, just so much better content in terms of objectives, right? This has been, I believe, is that really the only objective card throughout the whole of team of the year? Now, on to another point that I'm going to make. I think, now I'm not sure where they will do this. What would be very interesting if EA do go and start the team of the year under 23 idea. That would be very cool to see some obviously non-meta cards in the game get insane stats. Now, I know you're thinking, Matt, you know, Future Stars is around the corner. And it is. That promo, I'm looking forward to a hell of a lot. But if they did something creative, like have these, you know, obviously very good under 23 players get team of the year cards, Haaland, João Felix, who aren't always necessarily meta players. João Felix is very good. Haaland isn't always good in FIFA. But, you know, under 23 players who are meta would be great. And maybe like, that would be a step in the right direction, because Future Stars, when that happened, we were all like, oh my God, I can't wait to use, was it Martinelli from Arsenal? He got a Future Star card. Can't wait to use Saar, who scored, was it a hat-trick or two goals against for Watford? But more creative content is what people want to see. EA, you saw the reaction when Flashback Ronaldo got released. Like, I think I did a player review the other day on Ronaldo, and I couldn't believe like the support and that, the reaction to it. It was so positive. And we don't want to see this kind of obviously negative reaction to this massive promo. It's the biggest promo. The biggest promo of the entire FIFA calendar. And we're here wondering what could have been in this promo. There's so many incredible ideas and just creative content they could have done more of. We shouldn't be only having Jack Grealish as an objective player. We should be getting more, you know, usable players and just more better players, maybe some 90 rated players, maybe like a, well, to be honest, another point I wanted to make. So in regards to Flashback, I guess, well, Moment Suarez, I mean, if they'd like a, yeah, Moment Suarez from the FIFA, was it 18? And actually given him, you know, really good pace, that would have been sick. But obviously the pace on that card isn't great. Just small things like that, yeah, I think you can do a lot better at in terms of the content. I really feel like the content team can just deliver more. I believe them. I think they can, but it's got to be more consistent. Also, another thing for EA to know, if they ever want to talk about any future content in terms of ideas to get the best out of a promo, we're all here, man. We can talk to you guys. We had a meeting with EA regarding icon swaps. I did let you guys know about that like meeting we had. We had about, I think, 12 of us at that like meeting, in like a Zoom call, and that was pretty much on the day of icon swap. So obviously the content was already decided, but they wanted to give everyone like a heads up so we could talk to you guys in the community about what's about to happen in icon swaps. And yeah, like more things like that, but maybe ahead of time so we can, you know, avoid having a very underwhelming team of the year promo. That would be brilliant. I have reached out to EA today, so that would be brilliant if that would be possible. We want banging content, man. Like, we want really exciting content. The fact that we haven't really had any, I guess, I think the most exciting content in terms of packs this week was probably when the premium upgrade packs came out, and probably when the 83 plus attacker packs came out as well in SBCs. And that was actually nearly a week ago. And since then, it's just been like very similar. Attackers released, next day it's attacker packs. Midfielders release, the next day is midfielder packs. Defender packs, the next day defender packs. And I just feel like more creativity. The content that caught off guard, which was obviously Dybala, Ronaldo, Boateng, the community really enjoyed. So that's the positive. But having this level of pack weight from the premium upgrade packs, from in general the upgrade packs, and obviously the FIFA point packs has been, it's been the worst I've ever seen in any promo ever. I've never seen it like this. So I want that to be addressed as well, because obviously that's massively important. But let me know in the comments what you think about the entire Team of the Year promo. What content could EA do in a future Team of the Year promo that would make this brilliant? Please comment down below with your ideas, guys. I'll make sure to pin the best ideas and comments I do see on this video today. Also, there is more in regards to the community. So Ribery should have been better priced and more accessible. Flashback Team of the Year Kante, Flashback Team of the Year Varane, Prime Icon SBC, End of Era Rooney. As a casual, there was little content available to me. I do agree with that. The Flashback Ribery, guys, I have said it, I'm saying it again, is again overpriced. Like, if you look at the Ribery SBC, guys, right now, to make you aware of this, is still very expensive. My argument with this card is that as nice as this card potentially is, if you just look at the card itself, right, as a French left winger, 90 rating, very good stats, great, you know, traits there as well. But you've got to remember, like, his shapeshifter card from last FIFA was a CF, so I'd argue that might be more, you know, meta or more fun as well. You know, this Ribery card as CF would be deadly, actually. If he was a CF, that would be crazy. Anyway, his requirements, guys, are 84, 84, and then 86. I probably will eventually complete this over time or see, but at the same time, I'd be like, damn, this could have been two squads, 84 and then maybe 86, right? My reason being, I believe this Ribery SBC is around the price of Neymar. Now, Neymar is arguably the best left winger in the entirety of this game. Guys, Neymar is literally this price. I want to say, he's cheaper than that. He is, I think, 700k. And I'll double check on Footbin, but I believe Ribery is a very similar price to this kind of card. Now, this is obviously one of the best players in the game. He is insane in game. And yeah, you're paying pretty much the same price for Ribery's Neymar. And I know you get a few packs, but they're not exactly, you know, 50k packs and stuff. So things like that can be improved. Less squads for these, you know, players like Ribery. I think Ronaldo is very well priced, in my opinion. You might disagree with that. Feel free to comment down below. But yeah, like, again, these small things that could definitely improve Team of the Year would be brilliant. There is more, though. So, my man Bades tweeted out, Team of the Year has well and truly missed the mark this year. The players are fantastic. When you play with them, don't get me wrong. But everything around Team of the Year just feels off. It started when Muller wasn't a nominee and continuing today. I just want future stars now. And that was a Bates tweet there. And also, obviously, the big thing there was Sabitzer. Again, that was odd. And to get Fekir as a nominee, but not even Thomas Muller, again, is bizarre. So comment down below, guys, what you think regarding Team of the Year. What do you think EA missed out in terms of an opportunity for the biggest promo in the entire FIFA calendar? We can't forget that. It is meant to be the biggest promo. Players like Lewandowski should be 99 rated. Ronaldo, you know, Messi should all be 99s. That was also kind of strange. The pack look has to be improved. It is crazy how we only got one actually out of any upgrade packs from 1,300 packs, guys. That is the brutally honest pack look there from myself on streams this week. How has your pack look been? Let me know. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. If you support this video and I guess the general message regarding the Team of the Year promo, then do leave a like. That's very much appreciated, guys. I am doing a final send on, I believe, the League SBC packs for Team of the Year for tomorrow. I believe the Team of the Year does end at 6 p.m. tomorrow on Tuesday. So I'm going to get loads of these guys, loads of these done tonight, guys. So yeah, we'll get that done. I'll get, you know, West Brom players. West Brom have actually signed a centre midfielder, guys, who is a goal player. So that is great news. Anyway, have a special day, guys. I really wanted to bring this to your attention. Let me know any crazy ideas for future Team of the Year so EA can see the comment section of this video. Have a special day. Thank you for amazing support. And Team of the Year, guys, is nearly over.